Overview of liens in personal injury cases. What is a lien? A lien is a claim of a right to payment. It is common that liens are asserted in personal injury cases. The personal injury lien represents a claim of a right to payment from the proceeds received from any resulting settlement or judgment. Liens in personal injury cases are usually asserted by a medical provider or an insurance carrier. There are two types of liens that may be asserted. One, contractual liens, and two, statutory liens. Provisions for reimbursement are also considered liens, which will also require repayment only if there is a recovery. In contrast, subrogation allows for a right to directly sue the third-party tortfeasor, the party that caused the accident. There must be statutory authority for an insurance company or healthcare provider to have subrogation rights. Statutes that allow for subrogation include California Civil Code Section 3045.1 for hospital liens, California Labor Code Section 3856 for workers' compensation benefit reimbursements, California Government Code Section 23004.1 for county hospitals, and California Government Code 13963 for victims of violent crimes. What are contractual liens in a personal injury case? Contractual medical liens are claims for repayment based on an agreement between the injured party and the medical provider. These claims usually include health insurance reimbursement, medical treatment provided on lien basis, and MedPay provisions for reimbursement. Why is health insurance reimbursed in a personal injury case? Health insurance companies have a claim for reimbursement when the injuries that are treated are caused by a third party based on the contractual language in the injured victim's health insurance policy. Many health maintenance organizations, HMOs, like Kaiser, health insurance companies, including preferred provider organizations, PPOs, like Blue Cross Blue Shield, and other healthcare plans, will utilize boilerplate language in the patient contracts for a lien against any recovery by the insured for personal injuries from a third-party tortfeasor, the party that caused the accident. The lien provides for repayment of the medical expenses made on behalf of the injured party. Because there is no statutory authority allowing for the insurance company or healthcare plan to obtain an assignment of the tort cause of action from the injured party or allowing for subrogation rights to directly pursue a cause of action, the lien is purely contractual. Can a health insurance lien asserted in a personal injury case be reduced? Yes, a health insurance lien can be reduced pursuant to statute. California Civil Code Section 3040, Insurance Lien Reduction. California Civil Code Section 3040 provides for reductions and a cap on the health plan's contractual lien amount. The statute is very extensive and also applies to disability insurance lien claims. The California Civil Code Section 3040 codifies the comparative fault reduction, the common fund doctrine, and also places caps. No co-pays included in health insurance lien. All healthcare plan lien claims should be reviewed carefully to determine if they also include co-pays for the services rendered. The co-pays made by the injured party should not be included in the lien. Limits on non-capitated and capitated services. There are limits on the amount of the lien based on whether the healthcare provider billed for services as they were incurred, which is known as non-capitated, or whether the healthcare provider billed a flat fee, which is known as capitated. If the services are provided on a non-capitated basis, the injured party will receive an itemized bill. The health plan carrier will pay all or portion of the bill. California Civil Code Section 3040 limits the lien recovery for non-capitated services to the amount actually paid. If the services are provided on a capitated basis, the injured party will receive no itemization of the bill. This applies to Kaiser beneficiaries. California Civil Code Section 3040 limits the lien recovery for capitated services to 80% the usual and customary charge for the same services by medical providers that provide healthcare services on a non-capitated basis in the geographic region in which the services were rendered. That is, the gross capitated lien claim is reduced by 20%. However, when the healthcare provider that provides capitated services pays for a non-capitated service, such as an outside emergency room bill, that specific lien repayment is considered to be a reasonable cost charged and is not included in the reduction. Comparative fault reduction. In addition, a lien amount may be reduced pursuant to the insured's comparative fault. California Civil Code Section 3040 provides, where a final judgment includes a special finding by a judge, jury, or arbitrator that the enrollee or insured was partially at fault, the lien shall be reduced by the same comparative fault percentage by which the enrollee or insured's recovery was reduced. It is important to note that there must be a finding of comparative fault. Therefore, the percentage of comparative fault should be negotiated with the lien claimant prior to agreeing to a settlement in the personal injury case. If there is no special finding and the lien claimant is not willing to negotiate, the plaintiff's personal injury attorney can request that the third-party insurance adjuster put in writing that the settlement offer is made with consideration of a specific percentage of comparative fault assigned to the plaintiff. The Common Fund Doctrine. California Civil Code Section 3040 provides for a pro rata percentage reduction based on the insured's reasonable attorney's fees and costs. This codifies the Common Fund Doctrine. Essentially, the third party recovery effectively creates a common fund where not only will the injured party receive a benefit for having created the fund, but also the lien holder can draw from that same fund. Therefore, the lien holder should not get the benefit of free legal services required for obtaining the fund. Therefore, the lien holder should not get the benefit of free legal services required for obtaining the fund. The lien holder is required to share in the expenses, and the lien amount is therefore reduced accordingly. The lien recovery cap. California Civil Code Section 3040 provides for a cap on the amount recoverable on the lien. When an attorney is retained by the injured party, the health plan's lien claim may not exceed 1/3 of the money due to the injured party. When the injured party does not have an attorney, the lien claim may not exceed half of the money. The Made Whole Equitable Doctrine. The Made Whole Doctrine is a common law equitable principle that limits the ability of the insurer to exercise its right of subrogation because the injured plaintiff has not been fully compensated for the injuries and pain and suffering. In this situation, the injured plaintiff has not been made whole. The application of this equitable principle varies depending on the jurisdiction. This principle comes into play when the insurance policy is not sufficient enough to make the injured plaintiff whole by the settlement. How is medical treatment provided on a lien basis? Many times, the injured party may not have health insurance coverage. Nonetheless, the injured party is in need of medical care. Depending on the state law in the jurisdiction, many healthcare providers will provide treatment to the injured party provided they sign a lien to reimburse the expenses once a third-party recovery is obtained. Some states prohibit healthcare providers from treating on a lien basis when there may be third-party liability. For example, New York does not allow treatment on a lien, whereas in California, receiving treatment on a lien is an effective way to obtain the necessary care. Generally, the provider is not affiliated with any health insurance provider and usually includes individual medical practitioners, chiropractors, small health clinics, and x-ray facilities. Physical therapy, chiropractic treatment, orthopedic care, and surgeries may all be provided on a lien basis. The lien is purely contractual. An agreement is signed by the injured party and the healthcare provider. If the plaintiff's attorney also signs the agreement, the attorney has created a fiduciary duty with the lien holder to satisfy the claim. Moreover, California Civil Code Section 3040 does not apply to individual medical providers. In this situation, the made whole doctrine and the common fund doctrine cannot be applied to reduce the lien amount. What is MedPay? A lien is a contractual right based on a provision in an agreement that allows for reimbursement if a monetary recovery is obtained from a third party. Many times, an individual's own insurance policy agreement may provide for a lien owing to the insurance carrier for the amounts paid for medical expenses on behalf of the insured. The provision will require reimbursement if the insured obtains a monetary recovery from a third party. This type of provision is known as MedPay lien. There is no statute permitting reimbursement or subrogation rights to an insurance carrier. Therefore, MedPay provisions are purely contractual and must be set forth in the insurance contract. Automobile insurance MedPay. Many automobile insurance policy contracts provide for the payments of medical expenses for injuries resulting from an accident while driving in an insured vehicle, or while in a non-insured vehicle, or while in a non-owned vehicle, or as a pedestrian. For example, a passenger who does not own the vehicle and suffers an injury while in the vehicle which has MedPay coverage may be able to obtain medical payments from the vehicle's insurance. The passenger is considered a third-party beneficiary to the insurance contract. However, the passenger will be obligated to repay the insurance carrier for the payments received pursuant to the insurance contract provisions. Non-auto MedPay. Many non-automobile insurance policies may have a right to reimbursement even though the injured party does not make any recovery from a third-party tortfeasor, the party that caused the accident. Essentially, the MedPay provision provides for a credit to the insured, which will be a debt owed to the insurance carrier. The injured party's attorney will have a fiduciary duty to the lien claimant upon execution of a contract providing for the lien. Because the lien is a contractual right obligation, partial payment of the lien amount may not relieve the injured party from the still owing amount. If only partial payment can be made, it is necessary to have a stipulation in writing that this will satisfy the total obligation. Can a MedPay lien be reduced? MedPay liens may be reduced based on the common fund doctrine as codified in California Civil Code Section 3040 and also based on the made whole equitable doctrine. The common fund doctrine. California case law permits attorney's fees and costs to be deducted from the lien repayment. This is known as the common fund doctrine, which requires a pro rata share of fees and expenses so that the insurance company is not unjustly enriched by the legal services of the plaintiff's attorney that obtained the recovery, not only for the injured party, but also for the insurance company. California Civil Code Section 3040 codifies the common fund doctrine. The lien party must reduce its claim by its pro rata share of reasonable attorney fees and court costs required to prosecute the injured party's claim against the third-party tortfeasor. The made whole equitable doctrine. Before a lien is considered equitable and fair, the injured party must be fully compensated for the total injury by the third-party recovery. If a policy limit recovery does not fully compensate the injured party for the entire injury claim, then the injured party has not been made whole. The purpose of personal injury damages is to make the plaintiff whole. That is, put the injured party back in a position had they not been injured by awarding monetary compensation for the total loss. If the injured party has not been made whole by the third party recovery, the insured is not obligated to repay the medical payments made by the insurance carrier pursuant to the MedPay provision. However, the insurance policy contract may grant the carrier priority rights to the third-party recovery, which may preclude the made whole doctrine and allow the carrier to obtain repayment of the entire MedPay lien before the injured party receives any distribution from the recovery, even when priority rights are stated in the insurance policy contract. As a matter of law, the attorney's fees still have priority over medical liens, regardless of when the rights were created.